Suppose you shaved a lion and a tiger till they were both as bald as an egg. How would you tell which was which? Fingers on buzzers for this. General ignorance. Yes.
The tiger would be exactly the same size, but the lion would be, it would be the size of a squirrel. Because it's mainly hair.
It'd be mane and hair. It's a good thought. There is a more obvious way of telling. If you stripped them until they were just skeletons, it would be actually incredibly hard to tell. Only a real expert would know which was a lion skeleton and a tiger. They're almost identical. But if you were just to shave them until they're completely bald, you would know. And it's a rather odd thing.
Stripy skin?
Yes, the tiger would have stripes. It has stripy skin as well as stripy fur. And that's true of leopards and jaguars. So the lion would just be bald and white and the tiger would have the stripes.
I took my nephews to London Zoo because a friend of ours is a zookeeper there and she can get you in sort of the back. They wanted to see a lion and they said there's some mesh, there's small mesh and big mesh. You must stand on the side where the big mesh is. Don't go near the small mesh. Stay where the big mesh is. Do you understand? And the kids went... We just went in and my nephew turned to me and said, what's mesh?
I was in Brazil. I went into an enclosure with a jaguar and this handler, he said, he was Brazilian, and he said to me, very important, is always approach from the front. Like that, and I went, right, OK, and I just was sort of, like, getting closer to the front of it, and then he said, oh, no, sorry, never. Sorry. 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 My English.
Never and always.
Never and always. We lose a lot like that.
Anyway, that's true. Tigers are stripy even under their fur.